Thanks, Megan.
Well, pollster Frank Luntz has put together a focus group for us, picking a cross-section of voters from the key swing state of Florida tonight. And when it comes to creating moments, it looks like Bernie Sanders got some of the strongest reactions. Joining me now, CEO of Luntz Global, Frank Luntz. Hiya, Frank. What'd you find out?
Hey, Megan. Now, we got Democrats here, 28 Democrats. How many of you walked in here supporting Hillary Clinton? Raise your hands. Half of you. How many of you are still supporting Hillary Clinton? Only a small percentage. So who won in the debate?
Bernie Sanders!
Give me a word or phrase to describe Bernie Sanders tonight.
For the people.
Strong.
Straightforward.
Confident.
Insider and outsider.
Direct.
Sincere.
Powerful.
Educator.
Smart.
But he's a socialist. He actually answered the question about being a socialist. I know you're nodding your head, no. He's proud of being a socialist. Do you really think this guy can win? Do you? In the back.
I don't think he can. I don't think he can. He's a populist. I understand the appeal of his proposals, but I don't think he can win.
I think the unrest in the country regarding looking for radical change to some of the problems we've been facing is so deep that this could be the year that someone like that gets in.
So I want to show the people back home something. The highest moment of the debate, the one that this group thought was absolutely incredible, was about Hillary Clinton, but it wasn't delivered by Hillary Clinton. It was delivered by Bernie Sanders. Let's listen.
Let me say something that may not be great politics, but I think the secretary is right. And that is that the American people are sick and tired of hearing about your damn emails.
Thank you. Me too.
You know, the American people want to know whether we're going to have a democracy or an oligarchy as a result of Citizens United. Enough of the emails. Let's talk about the real issues facing America.
Thank you, Bernie.
Incredible. So I gotta ask you, why was that moment so powerful to you that you guys were in the 90s? I heard several people saying you wanted to turn your dial beyond 100. What was it?
He said, enough about the email. Let's get to the topics. He was almost protecting her and being a man about it, a gentleman, and say, let's get to what the real topics are. I thought that was very respectable.
Sorry. It's just such a non-issue. And I'm glad that he addressed it like that and got it out of the way.
What I liked is that he was stronger on the issue than she was, which scared me, because I wish that she would have said it to protect herself more than he had to say it for her.
This country is tired of the focus on personal infractions. We're looking at larger macro issues that face all of us. The emails are not one of those.
It was irrelevant.
And we have more issues going on in this country besides emails.
So are they connecting to you? Did this debate connect to you?
Yeah, it did, because this is the first time I've heard any of the candidates actually talk about real issues impacting, you know, Americans, as opposed to the Republicans who just, you know, kind of foment fear and I don't know what they're doing, but this was a good one.
Peter?
I thought it was great. It gave me the opportunity to learn and meet three potential candidates that I never met before.
But you didn't like two of them. How many of you want to kick Webb out of the debates? Raise your hands. How many of you want to kick Lincoln Chafee out of the debates? Raise your hands. So we had one winner and two big-time losers, but these Democrats and Democrats across the country are really happy for this debate. They thought they got the meat, they thought they got some good answers, and they're excited about their candidates.
Poor Jim Webb. Thanks, Frank. Well, Senator.